What's up, geometry students? Let's do this test review. This is a very comprehensive review of the test. If you can handle this, if you can do this twice, not make any mistakes on this, you are ready for your test. If you are just copying along, you're not ready. Starting off with simplifying radicals. The way I like to do it is find the biggest perfect square that divides into it. You can use a calculator if you want, or you could just try to do as much as you can and just break it down. Some perfect squares we should know: 49 is 7, square root of 36 is 6, we got the square root of 25, which is 5, got the square root of 16, which is 4, square root of 9, which is 3, square root of 4 is 2. Always important to try to find the biggest one. 16 goes into 32 twice. We should be thinking about what we're doing. It should always work out. 16 times 2 is 32. Root 16 times root 2 is root 32. I'm going to put 16 first because this is the perfect square. And this simplifies to be 4. And I got 4 root 2. Now, let's say you accidentally went the long way. And you said, well, 4 times 8 is 32. You're correct. 2 root 8 is almost what we're looking for. However, root 8 also has a 4 in it. And now we realize, oh, okay, 2 times 2 times root 2 is 4 root 2. So that's the answer. This is the short way, that's the long. Ooh, 60. I feel like I need to try 16 again. But that's not right. Why did I give you 60? You guys have a calculator? I'm going to break out my calculator just to show you. Cool. If you guys have a calculator, what's important is you can always double check to make sure your simplification is correct. The square root of 32. Square root of 32 is the same as 4 times the square root of 2. I don't know why that's so slow. Cool. Let's see. I know. I guess 4. Oh, look at that. Okay. Root 4, root 15. 2 root 15. Now, you might think, oh, isn't 15 5 times 3? Yeah, it is, but 5 and 3 are not perfect squares. So this is simplest radical form. Cool, that's why I gave you this next one. 34 can't be divided by 4. 34 can't be divided by 9. 34 can't be divided by 16. Like, there are some times, guys, where square roots can't be simplified. There is no perfect square that goes into root 34. On some of y'all's quiz, you like divided 34 by 3 and you're like, oh, it's, or what did you divide it by? 17? Yeah, 17. You're like, oh, this is 17 times 2. And it's like, you're right. Root 17 times root 2 is root 34. However, neither root 17 nor root 2 simplifies. Like, so this is like, fine. This is your answer. This is fully simplified. What some students did is write, this is 2 root 17, and that's not right. That's not right. And you could have checked it. Root 34, if you have a calculator, and you all should have a calculator for your test because we're letting you use one, is the same as 2 root 17. No, it's not. It's not. So that brings us to the next one, the square root of 121. I threw this in because, like, sometimes square roots can't simplify. Sometimes it's a perfect square, and the square root of 121 is 11. And, like, that's it. 11. Like, that's 11 times 11 is 121. So just being ready for situations like that when you're doing your problems. Sometimes when you're doing your problems, you're going to get the square root of a number and it's going to simplify. Sometimes when you're doing the problems, you're going to get a square root of a number and it can't simplify. Sometimes when you're doing your problems, you're going to get the square root of a number and it's this perfect number, like the square root of 121 is 11. So be ready for everything. Be ready to potentially get something and simplify it further. 3 times root 8, 3 times root 4 times root 2, 3 times 2 times root 2, 6 root 2. Same with this one. And that's prepping us for dealing with square roots. All right, number 2. Find the lengths requested. We have a bunch of word problems with right triangles. Okay, so drawing pictures are going to help us. Labeling things correctly is going to help us. And then the most famous formula of them all, the Pythagorean theorem, is also going to help us find the lengths that we're asked to find. Right triangle has a hypotenuse of 10. One leg is 5. What is the other leg? Don't assume it's 5. We don't know what it is, but we do know we have an A, a B, and a C. And A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Square root of 75. Okay. Is it a whole number? No. You can check. The square root of 75 is not a whole number. Cool. Okay. Does a perfect square go into it? Yes. I know 25 goes into 75. 25 times 3. So this can be simplified. Some of them can't be simplified. And that's okay. Just be ready for all three situations. Okay, next one. A right triangle has a hypotenuse length 10. One of its legs is twice as large as the other. Ooh, this is twice as large as that. Okay, well, I'm going to say this is X and this is 2X. What are the lengths of the legs? We did this on our quiz. We did this on the review for the quiz. We're ready for it. This is an A. This is a B. This is a C. Now, here's what's important, guys. A squared, B squared, C squared. We like to use parentheses when we're squaring. This shows up a lot with the equations of your circles, like parentheses squared, like this X distance squared plus this Y distance squared equals this radius squared. Okay. X squared plus 2X squared. 2X squared is 2X times 2X. 2X times 2X is 4X squared. 10 squared is 100. We get 5X squareds are 100. This is important. 1X squared plus 4X squareds are 5X squareds. That means after dividing both sides by 5, here's a big mistake a lot of students made on the quiz. Students square rooted. You can't square root both sides unless you square root the 5. And a lot of you did not square root the 5. You like just square rooted the x squared and then you divided by 5. But you have to divide by the square root of 5, which you didn't do. So we divide first and we get 20 and then we take the square root. So we get the square root of 20, which is root 4, root 5, which is 2 root 5. An isosceles right triangle has 2 side legs of 4. Okay, so it's isosceles. Isosceles means 2 of the side lengths are the same. Let me see if I can make that. That's fine. So this is 4. This is 4. What is the third side? Well, a squared plus b squared equals c squared. Now, let me show you something interesting here. I'm going to do this 2 different ways. If you think about it, sure, this is 16, this is 16, and this is 32. But couldn't I say this is like 2, four squareds, right? Okay, cool. Watch how we're going to get that answer. And you're not going to want to do this, but I'm just showing you. Square root of 32 is root 16 root 2. We talked about this, so we get 4 root 2. Okay, watch this. Square root both sides, and you have the square root of 2 and the square root of 4 squared. Oh, don't you have 2? The square root of 4 squared is the square root of 16, or like squares and square roots undo each other. You get 4 root 2 this way. It's just an interesting way how you can say 4 squared plus 4 squared is 2 4 squareds. I don't want you to worry about that, though. It's just fun for us math teachers. Next, cool little right triangle diagrams where we're going to have to like use the information to find a side, and then we're going to have to use that information to find the other side. So here is a right triangle with a 4 and a 5. We're going to have to find this. And then once we find this, we're going to have to go here. Now, it's very important to realize which are the A's, which are the B's, which are the C's. So this is an A. This is a B. This is a C. This is like a C here. So let's go. My first, we'll tackle this. I got a squared plus 16 equals 25. I get a squared equals 9. Many of you probably just automatically saw this triangle and said, oh, it's a 3, 4, 5 right triangle. It is the most famous three numbers that work in the Pythagorean theorem, 3, 4, 5. Then we need to work on this triangle. Well, 3 squared plus 6 squared equals x squared. Okay, 9 plus 36 equals x squared. This is 45 equals x squared. I will take the square root of both sides, and I know this is root 9, root 5. 3 root 5. Cool. Next. All right, I'm going to have to find this, so I'm going to work with this triangle first, and then I'll work with that triangle. A squared plus 9 squared equals 10 squared. This is an A. This is a C. Okay, so A squared plus 81 equals 100. A squared equals 19. A equals the square root of 19. Okay, and that's fine. Guess what? It's actually best that I don't simplify that, because I'm going to take that and square it anyways. 5 squared plus root 19 squared equals x squared. All right, that's easy. 25 plus 19 equals x squared, because the square root of 19 squared is going to be just 19. They undo each itself. So I got 30. I got 44 equals x squared. I got the square root, and boom, root 4, root 11. 2 root 11. Next. Ooh, given the 3 points shown, find all three lengths between the 3 points. Write three equations for the lines that connect the points. Does ABC make a right triangle? Why or why not? Great questions. Let's find the lengths. Okay, what we like to do to find lengths is just create a right triangle. So we have, thankfully, a grid system, which helps us makes this done easily. But we could also just say, like, I'm going from 0, 0 to 3, 2. This x length is 3. This y length is 2. Or you could just see this is 3, this is 2. You could see this is 3, this is 2, this is 0, 0. So the length of AB is going to be 3 squared plus 2 squared. So AB squared equals 9 plus 4, which is 13, which means AB is going to be the square root of 13, and that can't be simplified. All right, let's talk about BC. Well, BC squared. Has this length of 2 and this length of 3. Okay, look at this. It's going to be the same. I'm just going to go right to the answer. Since this is 3 and this is 2, we already dealt with that. All right, cool. And what about AC? Well, like, The easiest lengths in the coordinate system, and this is how the coordinate system was designed, the easiest lengths are ups and downs or lefts and rights. Could you use the Pythagorean theorem? Sure. Do you have to use the Pythagorean theorem? No, because I go up 1, 2, 3, 4. Four. Ah, cool. Write the three equations for the lines that connect the points. Okay. Let's start with the line AB. Let's use the point 0, 0. Or you can use the point 3, 2. We can use point slope form for any line, including if it has a y-intercept, it's fine. So AB, or we can use the point 3, 2, it doesn't matter. Y minus y1 equals the slope. Well, here's the slope. I got my ups and my overs. I go up 2 over 3, so I got 2/3 x minus 0. Cool. Let's find the line BC. Let's use the point 0, 4. So y minus 4 equals, okay, I go down 2 over 3. So this is important. If you went from 0, 4 to 3, 2, you could see that this is plus 3, but this is a minus 2. So y's over x's would be minus 2/3 x minus 0. And again, this does turn into a y-intercept form. And then what about AC? Well, the slope is vertical. It's undefined. What is the equation of a vertical line? Well, all of these points have an x-coordinate of 0. No matter where you look, all of these points have an x-coordinate of 0. This line of the y-axis is x equals 0. Okay, does ABC make a right triangle? Why or why not? Please. Analyze our equations and use the Pythagorean theorem and our lengths and analyze our lengths to figure out our answer. There's two ways of me saying no. And I want you to understand the two different ways. Well, this is root 13. This is root 13. This is 4. Does root 13 squared plus root 13 squared equal 4 squared? No. 13 plus 13 equaling 16? No, that doesn't work. So it doesn't follow the Pythagorean theorem. And the second thing is for there to be a right triangle, there needs to be a 90 degree angle, which means there needs to be perpendicular lines. These two equations are not perpendicular. AB is not perpendicular to BC. They are opposite slopes, but remember we need opposite reciprocal slopes to create a 90 degree angle. So there you go. No. Why? Pythagorean theorem, slope analysis. Okay, given the point 1, 2, negative 1, 8, connected by the line segment AB. Find the following. Okay. Always with these problems, always, I like to put down our x's and our y's, 1, 2, negative 1, 8. If I want to put it in that order, that's fine. It's okay. If I want to put it in a different order, that's fine as well. This is the change in my x's. This is my change in my y's. Or if you created the right triangle, you'd be able to see that as well. The slope. I go up 6, left 2, or I could go down 6, right 2. It's up to you which way you want to go. If I'm traveling from A to B, I'd say I went left 2, up 6. But it doesn't matter. You can have these flip-flopped. Regardless, the slope is the y's over the x's. The slope of the equation is 6 over negative 2, which is negative 3. The equation of the line, y minus 2 equals negative 3 x minus 1, or y minus 8 equals negative 3 x plus 1, and they would produce the same. These are not necessarily looks the same, but if you solve them for y, you would get the exact same thing. So that's good. Next, the distance between the two points. Okay, well, we already have this right triangle set up. We already know the x distance and the y distance, so we're going to use the Pythagorean theorem. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. 4 plus 36 equals c squared. 40 equals c squared. C equals root 40, which is root 4, root 10, which I'm comfortable with being the answer. Find the midpoint of AB. Well, I like doing the midpoint the following way. I like if I've already done the analysis that I go down 2 and I go up 6, go halfway between both. Go down 1, I get to 0. Go up 3, I get to 5. And that would be the midpoint. You could find the average of the two numbers, which a lot of you like just feel more comfortable doing because you don't want to, well, you just like formulas. I don't love formulas. I like to kind of just figure out, how do you find the middle? Well, we already know the length, so it's important to know that the midpoint is an x and a y. It's a point. It's a point in the middle. Find the equation of the circle centered in A that contains the point B. Well, here's where we understand A is the point 1, 2. Since we contain the point B, we know that the radius is the square root of 40. Now, I'm putting the square root of 40 on purpose. I could put 2 root 10, but I'm saying the radius is 40. But what I want and what's important for the equation of a circle is to give all possible x, y points that are root 40 away from 1, 2. This must be known, this must be known, and we want to find all of our possible x, y's. Now, if I go from 1, 2 to this theoretical x, y, just like we went from 2 to 8, you could subtract. 8 minus 2 is 6. 8 minus 2. Negative 1 minus 1 is negative 2. Negative 1 minus 1. You could find this length, this x length, by doing x minus 1. You could find this y length by finding y minus 2. This is not using really an equation. Yeah, come on in. Yeah, you're fine. Yeah. This is you understanding the lengths, the x length, the y length, and now we use the Pythagorean theorem. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. Many students did not on the quiz understand c squared. C is root 40. C squared is 40. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. If you want to write root 40 squared, that's fine, but that's just 40. Find the equation of the line tangent to the circle in part D passing through point B. Okay, now this is what's also important. We got this point, 1, 2. We got this point, 2, 8. -1, 8, sorry. What is the equation of this tangent line? Well, here's what you got to remember, that tangent lines create perpendicular angles with the radius. Perpendicular angles, opposite reciprocal slopes. We already found the slope of this, and we already found the equation of this. The slope of this was -3. That means the slope of this must be positive 1/3. Y minus 8 equals positive 1/3, x plus 1. Okay, point slope, I'm using the point negative 1, 8. Since the slope of this radius is negative 3, the slope of this tangent line has to be 1/3. All right, looks like this is the same deal. Negative 2, 3, 6, negative 1. What is the slope? What is the equation? Go from negative 2, 3 to 6, negative 1. I'm going to do 6 minus negative 2 and get plus 8. I'm going to do 3 minus negative 1, or negative 1 minus 3, and get negative 4. Y's over X's. Y's over X's. I got negative 1 half. Cool. And I can do Y minus 3 equals negative 1 half. X plus 2, or Y plus 1 equals negative 1 half x minus 6. So the distance, well, Pythagorean theorem, we got this length 4, this length 8. We already found that using these numbers. It shows up in our slope. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. 16 plus 64 equals c squared. C squared equals 70, 80. Does 16 go into 80? I feel like 16 might go into 80. Yeah, 5. I always try 16, guys. Find the midpoint. Well, you could find the midpoint by finding the average of these two sets of numbers. Or if you know you add 8, why don't you go halfway and add 4? You get to 2. If you know you subtract 4, why don't you go halfway and subtract 2, and you get to negative 1, and that's the midpoint right here. Circle centered at C, that contains D. All right, cool. Well, we know this length is root 80 is the length. So we're talking about C, negative 2, 3. Since it contains that point D, the radius is root 80. But for all of the points possible, we want to find all of the possible x spots. Cool. Well, this length is going to be x minus negative 2, or x plus 2. This length is going to be y minus 3. Again, if you go from negative 2, 3 to xy, this length is going to be x plus 2. This length is going to be y minus 3. Pythagorean theorem. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. We already found what c squared was. C squared was 80. C is root 80. Okay, but what would be the equation of that tangent line that passes through point D? Point D being 6, negative 1. Okay, well, the key is to remember that the radius and the tangent create a perpendicular line. We already found the slope of this. The slope of this line segment was negative 1/2. That means the slope of this line segment has to be 2. There we go. We have our point. We have our slope. Y minus y1 equals m times x minus x1. Okay, the line connecting negative 2, 1 and 2, negative 3. The line connecting the points are connected by a line segment that is a diameter of a circle. We are telling you that this is a diameter of a circle. Now, what's really important is a diameter goes through the middle and goes from one end of the circle on the other. Find M, which is the location of the middle of the circle. So let's find the midpoint. If this is the diameter of this circle that goes around, M is the midpoint. Let's find the midpoint. Well, if I add 4, add 2 to get to 0. If I subtract 4, subtract 2 to get to negative 1. 0, negative 1 is the midpoint, which is the center of the circle. Okay, so this is very different to the other problems that we had. The other problems that we had the two points were radius. Now the two points are the diameter and the midpoint is going to be like the middle. Okay, find the equation of the circle centered at M that contains the point J and K. The only way for us to find this is to find this radius length. The radius length, like right now, I have the center is 0, negative 1. But I don't know what this radius length is. And I want all of my possible xy's. So at least I know I have like x minus 0 squared. That's going to be the x distance. And then y minus negative 1 or y plus 1 squared. But let's find the length. How are we going to find the length? Well, we should be talking about these points or those points. We need to find either this length or that length. It's half of the overall length. We could calculate half of the overall length. But instead, it's probably easier to just split it into half. So if like we're going from 0, negative 1 to 2, negative 3, we know this is going to be minus 2, and this is going to be also minus 2. Sorry, this is plus 2, this is minus 2. You can see this is 2, this is 2. So we have 2 squared plus 2 squared equals c squared. This is going to be 2 root 2s because this is 4, this is 8. And the square root of 8 is root 4 root 2, which is 2 root 2. But remember, c is the square root of 8. C squared is 8. This is very important. I'm going to write that down again to make sure you understand. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. 8 equals c squared. A squared plus b squared equals c squared. Make sure you know when to use c. Make sure when you need to use c squared. In this situation, we need to use c. If I ask, what was the radius? The radius is root 8 or 2 root 2. That's how long the radius is. This is 2 root 2. However, c squared is 8. Okay, this is j. This is k. Find the equation of the tangent that passes through k. Well, we needed to know this slope. This slope is negative 1. So this line, therefore, has to have a slope of 1. Let's kind of clear some space off. If this slope is negative 1, this slope is 1. This is the point 2, negative 3. Y plus 3 equals positive 1, x minus 2. A circle is centered at 2, 3. It's all of the XYs with a very specific distance away from 2, 3. Well, if the circle has a radius 4, great. What's the equation? Easy. The X distance squared plus the Y distance squared equals C squared, the radius squared. If the X axis is tangent to the circle, I need to figure out what would be this length if this x-axis is tangent to the circle. Well, let's think about this point 2, 3. It's over 2, up 1, 2, 3. If the x-axis is tangent to the circle, then this length becomes 3. So it's x minus 2 squared plus y minus 3 squared equals 3 squared, the new radius. Ooh, what happens if I changed my mind and I said the y-axis is tangent to the circle? Okay, if the y-axis was tangent to the circle, then this line like this would be tangent to the circle. That means this length would be the length of my radius. What is the length of my radius here? Well, since this is the point 2, 3, I go over 2, up 1, 2, 3, over 2, this length is now 2. Which means we have x minus 2 squared plus y minus 3 squared equals 4. Notice like none of the equations change except for the radiuses, only the radiuses. Like we want all of the x, y points where my radius is 4, my radius is 3, or the radius is 2 because of all of the different lengths that we're talking about. 9FGH. I don't know how that showed up. What's the equation of the circle? Cool. Let's find all of these XY points that are 13 away from 5, negative 1. So this length is X minus 5. This length is Y plus 1. A squared plus B squared equals C squared. Write two horizontal and two vertical tangent equations to the circle. Oh, what a great question. Man, what a great question. Why do I say that's a great question? It's because you got to understand that point, the very bottom and the very top, the horizontal tangents will be there. This point, just to the left and just to the right, the vertical tangents will be there. How do we figure out where those are? Well, I got to understand my radius is 13. My radius is 13. My radius is 13. We got to take this point, 5, negative 1, and go 13 in every direction to find our new points. So this is like what we've talked about in the past, is like, what are the points? Four easy points on the circle. Well, if I want to go to the right 13, I'm going to be adding 13 to my x's. Adding 13 to my x's gives me the point 18, negative 1. Cool. If I go to left 13, I'm going to be subtracting 13, which is going to be negative 8, negative 1. That's this point right here. If I go up 13, adding 13 up, well, I add 13 to the y, and I'll get 5, 12. If I go down 13, be subtracting 13, you get 5, negative 14. Did that work out well? I feel like this is wrong. Oh, it's that five. That's what numbers were. Okay, cool. Now, what are the equations of these lines? Horizontal lines. The y's are always going to be consistent. This line is y equals negative 14. This line is y equals 12. This and this will give me that and that. What about here? All of these points will have the same x-coordinate. All of these points will have the same x-coordinate. The y's will change, but the x will always be negative 8, and the x will always be 18. Okay, so cool. Just going 13 in every direction. If the point 0, 12 is on the circle, which it is, what is the equation to the tangent? So maybe I'll just do another picture here. So we got this point 5, negative 1, and we got this point 0, 12. I know it's 13 away, but let's instead realize that it's the slope I care about because the tangent will create a perpendicular line. I go, left 5. Up 13, never mind. Left 5, up 13. I actually messed up. This is not true. This should be 0, 11. If you do it with 12 and you like don't check that the Pythagorean theorem works, you'll be fine. But let's say I fixed it. Cool. The slope of this line segment is 12 over negative 5. You can also check it by doing 5, negative 1, and 0, 11. I go down, up, 12, as I go down, 5. So y's over x's. This tangent line will create a perpendicular slope. It's got the point 0, 11. You could use the y-intercept form. Since this is the slope of this line, this slope will have to be positive 5 twelfths. And that's it. That's the units. It's less line heavy and line crazy as the quiz. That's fine. It's more heavier on the later stuff like circles and tangents. And that's fine as well. Do this three times. Do this twice. And you're good to go. Making sure you understand it and you're good to go. All right? Peace.